Hello guys, girls, and non-binary pals, I'm Kai and today I'll be teaching about overlay, the filter tool, preserve opacity, and clipping group. This was a tutorial requested from a friend, but I thought it might help some other people out as well. So first off, we have overlay. So what you do is, you add a layer, and if you look at your drawing, you think maybe, oh, it's a little bit too gray, or I'd rather have some other color over it that kind of brightens it up or something else. You can just, for instance, take the color red and just plop it over there. Change the little mode here to the side to overlay. And it has like a nice little red hue. You can, with opacity, can change it a bit to however you want it. And that's basically overlay. You can do this with whatever color, whatever you like. And if you don't feel like just picking the color from the side here, you could always use the filter tool, which is this little thing up here. If you open the filter tool, you can choose between hue and saturation, or brightness and contrast. I usually just pick hue and saturation. And from there, you have like three little sliders. The hue is obviously the color. You just swatch it around like a little rainbow. Do whatever you like. Like maybe you want a dark color, a bit of a cold color, big blue or whatever. Saturation is basically if you want more gray, more vibrant, a bit of the opacity a bit higher. You can purely see vibrancy and more gray. With the luminosity, it's either darker or lighter color. And that is basically the filter tool. Next off is preserve opacity. Preserve opacity I usually use for like line art or something else. You can basically use it for everything really. So you just swatch it in here to preserve opacity. And for instance, just take the color red again or whatever color you want. And you can start drawing over your line art and just stays inside the lines. And you can do this with whatever color you like. And just add more colors. Again, you want to make it a little rainbow or whatnot, you can just do that. And I'll give it a little bend to make it look more like one piece. And there you got it. And you can take the filter tool again and just do whatever. Basically, if you don't feel like using the preserve opacity tool because it's on the same layer, you can always make another layer above it and choose clipping group, which is basically the same thing, except now it's on a different layer, like keep safe or whatever. You can also just bucket it over there and then the clipping group that's in there, on there as well. And that's basically how it works.